Astonishing new details emerging about one of the richest and most powerful men in Los Angeles, real estate mogul and LA Clippers owner Donald Sterling. A racist rant caught on tape by an alleged former mistress got him banned for life from the NBA today. And now another woman's description reveals even more shocking details about Sterling. Here's ABC's Ryan Smith.
The decision came down like a slam dunk.
Effective immediately. I am banning Mr. Sterling for life from any association with the Clippers organization or the NBA.
Donald Sterling, the embattled billionaire owner of the Los Angeles Clippers, caught on tape making a racist rant and setting off a national firestorm of outrage, is out.
The views expressed by Mr. Sterling are deeply offensive and harmful.
In a bombshell press conference today, NBA Commissioner Adam Silver announced the harshest punishment ever handed down to a professional sports team owner. Banned from attending NBA games, banned from the Clippers practice facilities, banned from any say in the team's decisions, and banned from contacting the players.
I am also fining Mr. Sterling $2.5 million, the maximum amount allowed under the NBA Constitution.
The stunning announcement came after a league investigation confirmed the voice making those racist remarks in the recording is, in fact, Donald Sterling.
Yeah, it bothers me a lot that you want to broadcast that you're associating with black people.
The league's decision to remove Sterling as owner met with widespread praise across the basketball world.
We all started clapping because he handled it the right way.
After initial outrage, disappointment, and sadness, I think today is a very proud moment.
He did a wonderful thing today. You know, we love this diverse game, and, you know, hopefully the Clippers could begin their healing process.
The celebratory mood today is in stark contrast to the fierce outrage when those recordings first surfaced over the weekend.
Don't come to my games. Don't bring black people and don't come.
Recordings of Donald Sterling, worth an estimated $1.9 billion, speaking to his alleged former mistress, V. Stiviano, earlier this month after she posted a photo of herself and Hall of Famer Irvin Magic Johnson on Instagram.
Don't put them on Instagram so the world has to see it, so they have to call me. And don't bring them into my games, okay?
Do you know that you have a whole team that's black that plays for you?
Do I know? I support them and give them food. And clothes, and cars, and houses.
Stiviano, pictured here today riding roller skates outside her home in Los Angeles, said through her attorney that she never had a sexual or romantic relationship with Sterling, and, quote, she's not the type of person everyone says.
Are you a racist, Mr. Sterling?
Still no word from Sterling himself. He was last seen leaving a steakhouse in L.A. with his estranged wife on Sunday night. When asked if her husband is a racist...
No, of course not.
I'm looking at it like I look at other investments.
But Sterling, who bought the Clippers in 1981 for $12 million, has a long history of racial controversy. He has been sued for racial discrimination over his alleged refusal to rent apartments to minorities and relationships with other women that also ended up in court. According to 2003 court documents uncovered by ABC News, he allegedly repaid the tenderness of one woman with belittling scorn. According to the woman, quote, I cooked meals for him, chauffeured him, acted as his confidant. According to Sterling, quote, she wanted to have sex as much as possible because she felt she should get paid every time. The woman also said, quote, he often boasted about his ability to destroy anyone who dared to oppose him. They later settled the case privately. That hot water back then, nothing compared to the boiling rage he faced this week. This from Magic Johnson.
He's got to give up the team. If he doesn't like African-Americans and you're in a league that's over 70% African-American.
Ding, ding.
And Charles Barkley, who called for the NBA commissioner to suspend him on TNT's halftime report.
You can't have this guy making statements like that. He has to suspend him and fine him immediately. We cannot have an NBA owner discriminating against a league that we're a black league.
Even President Obama weighed in.
When ignorant folks want to advertise their ignorance, you don't really have to do anything. You just let them talk.
As for the Clippers, a silent protest. Players removing their warm-up jackets and wearing their shooting shirts inside out to hide the Clippers logo.
You know, I think fans are stunned.
Clipper fans are thinking, hey, this is our first year that we can be relevant. They've got a chance to go to the championship, and now they have to deal with this cloud of controversy.
Other teams standing with them. The Miami Heat turned their warm-ups inside out before their game last night versus the Charlotte Bobcats. As the pressure mounted on the NBA to act, the basketball world watched with bated breath as the commissioner took the podium today under a white-hot spotlight only months into his tenure, delivering a message loud and clear. Sterling is not fit to own an NBA team.
The views expressed by Mr. Sterling are deeply offensive and harmful. We stand together in condemning Mr. Sterling's views. They simply have no place in the NBA.
And he wants to force him to sell it.
I will urge the Board of Governors to exercise its authority to force a sale of the team and will do everything in my power to ensure that that happens.
Now it's up to the other NBA team owners.
I will 100% support Commissioner Silver on this.
Owners like Vivek Ranadive, who recently bought the Sacramento Kings, and as an Indian American, is a minority himself.
I came here at the age of 16 or 17 with $50 in my pocket, and I have never encountered any kind of racism. And the NBA is colorblind. They've received me with open arms.
He says owners like Sterling are the exception.
My experience with the owners has been that they're amazing people. They're colorblind. They recognize that basketball is a global sport. It's the sport of the 21st century. And that there's a code of conduct that's expected.
Legendary player Shaquille O'Neal, now also a part owner of the Sacramento Kings, stands by the commissioner.
They have strong evidence now, you know, especially after hearing Mr. Sterling on the tapes. And, you know, the way Mr. Silver handled it was beautifully done.
According to the league's constitution, the commissioner will need 75% of owners to help force Sterling out. Other reactions to the league's unprecedented decision have been flooding in.
Adam Silver today was fantastic. Personally, I thought he made a decision that really was the right one.
Former NBA great Kevin Johnson, representing all the players, said this ugly episode should serve as a warning.
I hope that every bigot in this country sees what happened to Mr. Sterling and recognizes that if he can fall, so can you.
It was a great day for the NBA. It was a great day for all people of all races, but especially, you know, African Americans.
As the Clippers took the court tonight, the fans were celebrating what seems to have become the new Clippers motto, "We are one."
Ooh,
for Nightline, I'm Ryan Smith in Los Angeles.
See?